I'm Nathan Olivares-Giles, technology reporter with the Los Angeles Times, and this is the Galaxy Nexus, the latest Android smartphone built by Samsung, and it is the best Android smartphone to date, running the best version of Android to date, which is expected because it is the newest and latest hardware and software. Now, as far as the hardware goes, you do have the top-of-the-line specs, which is what you'd expect from a $300 price tag on a two-year contract from Verizon. So what does that get you? A 4.65-inch display, which is pretty massive. You have a 1280 by 720p resolution on that screen, and it looks fantastic. Videos, music, websites, they all load quickly thanks to the hardware, and they look great. Now, to go along with that big, beautiful, crisp display here, we have 1 gigabyte of RAM, a 1.2 gigahertz dual-core processor, 32 gigabytes of built-in storage. This is all top-end, you know, high-end stuff here for smartphones. On the back, we have a 5-megapixel camera that can shoot up to 1080p video. Now, the photos that I took with the camera were good, but they weren't as good as some other 8-megapixel cameras that I've seen on other Android smartphones or the iPhone, for instance. Good, but not great. On the front, we have a 1.3-megapixel video camera that is really nice for video chats, Google Plus Hangouts, and anything you want to do with that. Now, the Galaxy Nexus, it is undeniably a Samsung phone. Why? Well, you have the curved display here that was brought over from the Nexus S. That's the last generation Nexus phone. And then on the back, we have some unfortunately cheap-feeling plastic, which is brought over from the Galaxy S and the Galaxy S2. Overall, it's an understated look, and it's a really nice phone. It's thin, it's light, it feels good in your hand, but you're not going to get some of the premium materials on this device like you might see on the iPhone or the Droid Razr and other high-end handsets out there. Now, as good as the hardware here is, the best part of the Galaxy Nexus is ice cream sandwich. It's the software. One thing that I really do like here is there are no more physical buttons on the face of the phone. Instead of 4 buttons built into the phone, you now have 3 on-screen buttons here. A back button to get you out of whatever you're doing, a home button which takes you to your home screen, and then a button to see what other apps you have running in the background. To get rid of one of those apps, you just swipe it off the screen, left or right. And that motion repeats itself. That's kind of how you navigate an ice cream sandwich. You want to look at your other home screens? Swipe left or right. You want to see what other apps you have running in your settings menu or your apps and widgets menu? Swipe left or right. This is really, really simple, and it's repeated everywhere. And it's one more example of Google really thinking about Android from the top down when they were designing ice cream sandwich. We finally actually have folders here in Android Ice Cream Sandwich. To include an app in a folder or to create a folder, you just drag one icon over the top of another. Pretty simple, straightforward. Everything to do in Ice Cream Sandwich is easier than it has been before in other versions of Android, and this is the first version of Android that I actually really enjoy using. One feature in Ice Cream Sandwich that could be really cool or really creepy, depending on how you look at it, is Face Unlock. There's facial recognition software in Ice Cream Sandwich, and instead of having to put in a passcode to unlock the phone, it can actually recognize that you are you and get you into the phone. Now, that could actually be a hazard. I took a picture of myself with another smartphone, held it up in front of the Galaxy Nexus, and that unlocked the phone. Now, the combination of the Galaxy Nexus hardware with Ice Cream Sandwich in its purest form makes this, in my opinion, the best Android phone ever made. If you're looking for an Android handset, this is the one I think you should go for.